In the following example, we're asked to integrate 5 cosine to the power 4 of x. You'll notice here I wrote cosine squared of x equals 1 half plus 1 half cosine 2x, which is double angle formula solved for cosine squared that you would have learned about in your previous math course. So we're going to use that to solve this question. If you look at the rules we've covered in class, this one fits into the both even category. Even though the sine is not present, we do have an even power of cosine. So the rule tells us to replace cosine squared, or all the cosine squareds, using this formula. So we can write 5, we'll get rid of the constant, and we'll put in this for cosine squared. So that's 1/2 plus 1/2 cosine of 2x. And since we have power 4, that actually needs to be squared. So if we expand here now, we get 5 times the integral of 1 over 4 plus 1/2 cosine of 2x plus 1/4 cosine squared of 2x. dx. And that's just from algebraically expanding this bracket. Square the first, square the last, 2 times the first times the second. If we break it into 3 separate integrals now and remove the constants all at once, then we end up with 5 over 4 times the integral of dx plus 5 over 2 times the integral of cosine 2x dx plus 5 over 4 the integral of cosine squared of 2x dx. So if we look now at each of these 3 integrals, this one we can solve, this one we can solve, this one has cosine squared, so we have to repeat the same step again, so we'll replace cosine squared with this. And so as we go across now, we'll do each of those steps. 5 over 4, integral of dx is x, so that's done. Plus 5 over 2. Integral of cosine 2x is sine 2x, but it's sine 2x, which means we have to divide by 2. If you're not sure where the over 2 comes from, you probably need to do a little more practice, but try just taking this part by itself, and with u substitution, set u equal to 2x, and hopefully you'll see where the 2 comes from there. So that's plus 5 over 4, and for this one, we're going to have to use this substitution again. So that's 1/2 plus 1/2 cosine. Now this is the rule for x giving 2x. We already have 2x, so that's going to give us 4x here, dx. Now we're going to break it into parts again like we did here, and we'll write all the steps. So this is 5 sine 2x, and that's over 4, and we'll just leave the 4 there. Plus, this is 5 over 8 times the integral of dx, plus, and this one's going to be 5 over 8, we're bringing the constant in with both, times the integral of cosine 4x dx. So going across now, we can integrate this, we can integrate this, so we can get our final answer. 5 over 4x plus 5 over 4 sine of 2x plus 5 over 8 integral of dx is x plus 5 over 8 integral of cosine of 4x is going to be sine of 4x. And that's got to be over 4, for the same reason this one was over 2. Again, not sure where that 4 comes from. Take this, separate, work it out using u substitution. And that's all plus c, since now we're finished all the integrals. 5 over 4x and 5 over 8x can go together. Sine 2x and sine 4x have different arguments, so we can't simplify those without trig identities, so we'll leave those. And get the final answer of 15 over 8x plus 5 over 4 sine of 2x plus 5 over 32 sine of 4x plus a constant. Now, just out of interest here, I've mentioned in class this Wolfgram site for solving some integrals, and we'll try to keep our answer there. But if we go to this website here, wolfgramalpha.com, and type in integrate 5 cosine to the 4 of x, which was our original question, we can just hit enter or compute here and see if we get the same result. And this is a great tool to use to check your answer. Here you notice you can click show steps and find out how the answer comes about. So you notice our answer doesn't quite match. The difference between the two of these is they've factored out this 5 over 32, leaving 12 and 8 here. But if you scroll down, it gives alternative forms of the answer. So different simplifications maybe, and you notice here, this is exactly the same result that we got. So this is great doing assignments, doing practice at home to check your answer. When you're stuck, bring it up, show the steps to get it. So if we load the steps here quickly, it says first factor out the 5. Use a reduction formula, so this is actually a slightly different look than we did, but that is possible. Okay. This here is the same way we solved this part. Write cosine squared as a half cosine 2x plus a half. Only in our case we put a half first, plus a half cosine 2x. But this is very similar, if not exactly the same procedure. Here you notice they show the substitution so that you know why it's sine over 2 or sine over 4 in each of our steps. So don't hesitate to use that when you're practicing at home. It can only help.